biggest station in the world, playing all of today's hits. You're listening to Instinct Radio.
Tonight's episode is sponsored by Maverick Entertainment Group, celebrating 20 years of urban entertainment.
What's up, people? This is your boy, Bernard McCoy. It's about to go down tonight from 8 p.m. until 10 p.m. TPN Live, none other than Bobby and Renee Peoples on InstinctRadio.net. Now, download the app at Apple Store or on Google Play. Now, tonight, we got Productions, Rasheda, Randle, director, writer, and producer, along with Rodney Jackson, COO of 480 Films. Here tonight, TPN Radio. Hey, get your laptop, get your computer, get your phone, whatever. Get on the line and call in at 478-569-6474. TPN Live, here we go. Let's go.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're now tuned in to the very best. It's yours truly, Jazzy. Fizzle, fizzle, fizzle. And this is Instinct Radio, man. Tune in, baby. Oh, boy.
Yo, what's up?
Hey, this is what's up,
Bobby
y'all?
And Renee, TPN Live with Bobby and Renee, not That's TPN right. Live, like some of y'all be saying.
Well, you gotta bring up old stuff.
I mean, it was just 2 weeks ago you said that.
No.
You was like,
no.
TPN
okay.
Live with Bobby and Renee.
We're gonna ignore him right now, guys.
Why? Why are you ignoring
me? We're gonna ignore him because...
Because of.
I didn't mean to say TPN Live. I meant to say TPN Live. I know the name of our radio station.
Oh, do you?
Yes, I do.
I got you. So tonight we got some very good guests coming up tonight, don't you think?
Yes, we do.
Who we got?
We have Rodney Jackson.
Who? Now, who's Rodney? Who's Rodney?
Can I say it, though?
Okay, well, who's Rodney?
Can I say it?
No, you can't say it.
Gosh. COO of 480 Films, y'all. Mm-hmm. Y'all got to give it up for Rodney. He's coming on tonight. We are super excited. And we do have a special surprise guest as well. His boys, they got something going on.
Yes.
Yeah,
very
baby.
Talented,
so
we're very about talented
to find
babies.
Out. Y'all know we love the kids, y'all. Yeah. So we're about to find out what's going on with
like
the baby.
I like making kids, too.
It shows you have seven.
I know.
So anyway,
you need to catch up.
Back to the show, y'all. We are super excited. Mm-hmm. The next guest we have coming on after Rodney is who?
Rasheda Randle.
Yes, Miss Rasheda.
Yeah, she's gonna be talking about her world tour she just came off of.
Yes, honey. Yes, I love it. Female director. She's mm-hmm. doing her thing, y'all. Y'all gotta make sure y'all stay tuned because I can't wait to hear about this trip and about everything that she has going on with her.
She does
movie
a lot. Yes, yes. She got back from the film fest too.
Yeah.
So we'll talk about that as well.
Yeah.
And also, she also, people who do know Rasheda, she also hosts our TPN Film Fest red carpet.
Yes, yes. It rotates between her and Miss Chelsea Ray. And so y'all make sure y'all stay tuned. We are super excited about our guest tonight, y'all. Oh, we also going to do a little gossiping as well. We want to talk about this invisible beefing in the film community and see how we can squash that.
But it's squashed. Yeah. All that stuff is done. We also going to talk about, we're going to show the actual premiere of our trailer to the movie Fixation.
Yes, so y'all make sure y'all stay tuned. If y'all want to see that trailer tonight.
Stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
You know what I'm saying? Don't be like coming in to see a trailer and leave. We want y'all to stick around and stay. What you got going on, though?
Wait, what you got going on? That wasn't one of our questions.
I'm asking you a question
you
now.
You can't catch me off guard like that.
Well, I can't.
I'm not being interviewed.
You from D-Town.
Hey, y'all.
Hey, you know that song? It's Cold in the D. That's a little cousin.
Oh, no, you didn't. Hold on. First of all.
That's
okay, y'all, Google that video. Okay, Google
it's
that
video.
When I seen that video, I was so
Renee actually
upset.
Wrote the lyrics to that song.
And you're going to just keep on lying.
No, I'm not lying.
You're just going to keep lying,
you
Mr. People.
You ain't write the song.
Y'all, I was so upset when I heard that song. All that talent we have in Detroit, Michigan, and that song kind of blew up and went, like, cyber famous.
What?
Oh, yeah, I was really upset
Why
about
was you
that.
Upset about that,
I was
though?
Really upset
you
about
hating?
That. Was you and hating? Then they had the church rock going on. Y'all gotta go Google that song,
no, don't,
y'all.
Don't Google that song. Don't do it.
Listen, y'all, when they start doing the church rock, y'all just go ahead and rock with them, all right? Just they, go ahead
and
rock.
They all went to Renee's church, so she know about that church rock.
Whatever, man. Whatever.
She'll watch the videos. Oh, I remember that spot. I remember those days. You weren't doing that.
No, I was not. Well, yeah, I did kind of. I was like, oh, that's the Coney Island down the street. Oh, yeah, I know where that's at. But, yeah, it was not good, y'all. It was not good.
And we also going to be taking some live questions tonight, too, guys. Yes, so we got our Facebook Live up. If you got any questions tonight, Renee will read them off.
Yes. Hey, Sylvia. Hey, Chelsea. Hey, Larry.
Hey, everybody on. So yeah, what we're about to do now, we're about to go into our first break. When we come back. Mm-hmm. We're going to have our first guest, yes. Mr. Rodney Jackson. All right, so let's go pay these bills right quick, and we'll be right back.
All right.
Hi, my name is Cassia Hart, and you're watching TPN Live with Bobby and Renee.
This is John Sylvie.
This is Haley Sylvie.
This is Haley Sylvie.
And you are watching TPN Live with
Bobby
Renee.
Enjoy.
Different flavors make the world go around. And now try the flavor of hot honey mustard on the boneless wings meal. Served with crinkle fries, Texas toast, and a 22-ounce drink. Friends, family, flavor. Zaxby's. Indescribably good.
Honey, wonder if your wife knows you're here right now.
Your dad plays professional football, right?
Tell us a little bit about the movie.
Hello, indie fans. Today I'm here with Eduardo Castrillo.
Filmmaker. Only with Maverick Entertainment, home to the best indie movies.
Hello, it's Cynthia Deck, a.k.a. Queen of Abs, and you're watching TPN Live with Bobby and Renee.
It's your boy, Darryl Dan, man. I am chilling on the motherfucking couch watching TPN Live, man, with Bobby and Renee, man. That nigga Bobby is a goddamn fool. You feel me?
The biggest station in the world, playing all of today's hits. We're listening to Instinct Radio.
All right. Told you we come back with Mr. Rodney Jackson,
yes.
The COO of 480 Films.
Yeah, I'm gonna be ignorant.
I don't know what COO means. So tell me what that means.
Basically, I'm second in command.
Okay. Oh well, that's Renee, right. You're COO.
I'm a CEO.
Oh, why you can't be a COO? You're in second in command. I'm taller.
I can't stand. we're gonna go through this power struggle right now.
you know, Tavares is, you know, the founder.
Got you.
And of course he's top billing, but yeah, we run.
Y'all run things. Okay. Awesome. All right. So now I know you, but for people out there who don't know the history of 480, run down how long y'all been in the game.
Oh geez. Tavares has been in way longer than me. Myself has been 9 years.
That's mm-hmm. it?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
I could have thought it'd been longer than that. Because I know you longer than 9 years. Because I've been here 10. I think I know when I first got here.
Yeah, I think it's been about 9 years. You know what? I'm bad when it comes to that. I want to say it's about 9. If it's 10 years, I'll be surprised.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. So what made you get into the game?
What made me get into the game was, first of all, you know, I just loved the acting. I love movies, period. But I loved acting. So when I used to be in theater when I was in high school and whatnot.
Okay.
When I got down here, it was more so to try to get my kids opportunities.
Gotcha.
And be honest with you, I knew I wanted to do something in entertainment, but I kind of pictured myself as being like Ari Gold from Entourage.
Yeah, yeah, you want to be an agent?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Like, you know, making things happen for talented people.
Okay.
I always felt like I could be of service.
Okay.
To talent.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, how I got the, you know, directing and shooting is honestly was out of necessity for, you know, our brand.
Okay.
We've all been through it.
Yeah.
Where, you know, you get a project and then all of a sudden things don't exactly start going right.
That's right. That's right.
People fall off. And
we
then,
know about that.
Yeah. Yeah. So, you know, that's what made me want, you know, learn how to direct, learn how to edit, learn how to shoot. And that is my smartwatch being a little too smart.
I'm there, sorry. You go.
Okay. I was like, what is that talking?
That's my smartwatch.
Oh, okay.
A little too smart.
Hey. Nice.
I'm with you. So you said when you got, where you from? Where you from?
I'm from Baltimore, Maryland.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, yeah. DMV up in the house. All right. Okay.
Yeah. Park Heights.
Nice. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So you say you got directed out of necessity. Like, what was that project, if you don't mind telling, that turning point that made, you know what, forget, bring other people on, I'm going to do this myself. What was that turning point? What was that?
It was a project called Idle Times.
Okay.
That we had gotten into business with an entity that, you know, told what a lot of us young filmmakers love to hear. We can do this.
Oh, we can do that. A lot of that in ATL, baby.
Yeah. Yeah. And so we went full bore into this project. And what wound up happening is, quite honestly, like a lot of situations like this, they weren't able to deliver.
Mm-hmm.
And so slowly but surely, you know, things started happening. People started falling off. So, you can feel it in your mm-hmm. spirit.
Mm-hmm.
So, it was on that project. Was like, well, let me go and buy a camera.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Let me go and buy a camera just in case. And then, okay, well, let me go and get Adobe Premiere
uh-huh.
just in case. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Let me go get some lights just in case.
Just in case. Right. That's right.
And before you know it, I'm about on my, you know, fifth feature film.
But you said something very important, because I got a lot of people asking, yo, can I come be on your set, working your set? And I say no, because I've been there, had people come on set, and like, they come for one day, and then like, what the hell are you at the next day when I need you? Mm-hmm. So, and what happens, you start
really
being dependent on that person. I'm like, you know what, I'm not going to ever be dependent. So, you guys hear, you know, this is what happens. We can't be dependent, y'all. We have to do our own stuff, and out of necessity, we're where we are now because of that. So
exactly. Yeah. And you know, the thing is, it makes a person like me, because I, as a person, I'm very open. I'm mm-hmm. very trusting. And it makes a person like me kind of shell up.
Yeah.
And mm-hmm. and certainly, you know, me and Tavares have that in common. We like people and we like working with people, we are very, very trusting.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And we give our all to them. We give our all. We are very loyal people. Loyal to a fault sometimes.
Oh, yeah. Gotcha. Mm-hmm.
And that makes us kind of shell up. And I know sometimes the perception out there is, oh, you know, 480 don't like working with people. And it's like, no, it's not that. It's just we've been through so much.
Yeah.
You know, mm-hmm. we've been through so much and for us to get to the point where we are right now, and it's amazing. And we just, you know, we just want to work with people that we feel confident.
I got mm-hmm. that. Mm-hmm. And speaking of that too, because we're label mates.
That's right.
So we're a label mate. So yes. And people understand that y'all got a movie that this came out. What was it? January 10th.
Yeah.
January 10th. Flesh. Now, we're gonna show y'all the trailer to that movie, but if you haven't gotten that movie yet, you guys need to go get that.
Make sure you go out. Yes.
Talk to a little bit about that process of making Flesh.
Well, man, you know, honestly, what we were wanting to do is just we took a look at the indie scene landscape in Atlanta at the time, and we like, well, you know, we wanted to make something that was going to stick in the minds of people after they see it. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, when he wrote Flesh, he wrote Flesh basically after reading about, you know, Atlanta being like the number one city in the United States for human trafficking. Mm. Something that is mind blowing. Yes. You would have never thought.
It's crazy.
You know? Mm-hmm. But so you know, once again, you know, as Tavares being so talented, he wrote that script in a day.
Wow.
He wrote it. He's an amazing writer. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, I'm looking at this and I'm like, okay, well, T, if we're going to do this, we got to go all the way.
Yeah.
Like we can't hold back.
That's right.
And so, and you know, some scenes specifically, I know I just wanted the stay with people, mm-hmm, after they seen it, and mm-hmm, and I think we accomplished that with, mm-hmm, Flesh. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a fun movie in some regards, but you know, there's, you know, a couple scenes that are very uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and,
I mean, but yeah, that's because you're dealing with an uncomfortable subject.
Right. Yeah. I mean, right, the subject itself, right, would make you uncomfortable. Cool. So we're about to go into the trailer real quick. And how you want to set this up for us? Like, you know, talk to about the trailer a little bit.
Well, it's a trailer. at the beginning of the trailer, you see one of the stars of the film, a talented young actor. His name is Nasir Rahim, and
Nas?
He's amazing.
Yeah, Nas,
like,
is amazing.
Let me tell you one thing. Nas had everybody on that set like on the A game. Mm-hmm. Like, I think he did this one scene where he, you know, I'm not going
to tell the movie,
but he had to, you know, like really
get into
mm-hmm, it.
Yeah.
And when he did that and he knocked it out, you just saw everybody was like, oh.
Oh,
okay.
I can't wait to see it. Yes,
hey,
come
let's
on.
Go ahead, let's go to that Flesh trailer real quick and so people can see what you're talking about.
Yes.
All right.
So, what do you know about this Eve chick?
That she means business. Cartels are behind her. She's very powerful.
So she's already approached you?
She has.
And?
Business is business, right? Obviously, I'm smarter than you, Casper. It's prostitution. What's the difference?
You have a daughter, don't you, Marcella?
Yeah.
She's still up at that little private school up north, right? What happens if she's snatched up and sold? It's not prostitution, you dumb prick. I tell you what. You can sit back and watch a movie on you. But it ain't gonna happen to me.
Tell a friend to tell a friend. Download the app on Google Play, Instinct Radio, or go to instinctradio.net. And now, back to the hottest sounds around. Instinct Radio.
All right.
All right. What y'all think about that trailer, man? Ooh. That scoring is hot.
Yeah, oh, I love
that. That is hot. Yeah. Yes. Definitely. Whoever scored that, I mean, that was just awesome.
That's my boy. You know, his name is, oh, good grief.
No, you lied, man. Oh, you lied.
No.
It'll come back. It'll come to
it'll
you.
It'll come back. Mm-hmm. But he not only did the scoring, he also edited the movie.
Okay. Okay.
So right now, my old man memory is messing with me.
That's all good. Yeah. So how long did it take you out of actually film Flesh?
Flesh was 3 months.
3 months? Yep. Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, three months. Three hard months. It was 3 hard months, but yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Three. Well, I mean, it looks good. The quality is great.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually out there in Walmart.com, BestBuy.com, BarnesandNobles.com. I mean, this is my label mate, so, hey, you guys got to support. I ordered my copy. I'm just waiting for it to hit the shelf, talking about another copy.
Oh, yeah. You know
what I'm saying? That's how we're gonna do, because we're gonna do a sighting. We found a flesh sighting, so we gotta do that.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? So I know everybody wondering, like, we got more people in here. So we wanna go around the table and have them introduce themselves. Start with you, young man.
My name is Elijah Jackson, just 16-year-old boy from Atlanta, and son of Rodney Jackson.
Okay, all right.
All right. Hi, Erica Sutherland. Nice to meet y'all.
Okay.
Both up in the ether.
All right. My name's Xander Jackson, just 12-year-old boy, just like my brother right there.
Boy, these boys got some deep voices.
I know, I'm like, some deep, powerful voices,
okay.
Too.
Now,
that's awesome.
Xander and, I'm sorry.
Elijah.
I can't remember that. So your dad said y'all got some things coming up. You care to elaborate on, you know, what dad was talking about?
I got some things coming up because I'm a magician.
Yeah, I heard.
And the magic I do is a bit unlike the magic other people before me have done, because, you know, I'm younger and I'm black. So
I would never guess that. I never would have guessed you're younger or black.
I'm leading ahead type of magic that's unlike what people have seen before, because I'm not, you know, the stage top hat suit type of guy with all the big boxes and swords and
stuff like
that.
So is this something that you want to do going to as a career path?
Yes,
so you don't want to do what dad's doing, the filmmaking stuff. I've seen you on set, so I know you can do it.
I just like to help out.
Okay, all right. And what about you, young Xander?
I just came. I usually just like to play games and stuff. I usually just play, like, you know, typical games and stuff like that.
So what's your best game right now you're playing right now?
Well, this is probably typical since it's like 2017 Minecraft, of course.
I don't understand that. I don't get it.
My son plays Minecraft.
It's an art form.
Apparently now
it's an art form. So it's like if you're an actor or you're a painter or you're a Minecrafter.
Minecrafter. Okay.
Call of Duty would be my second one.
I've seen that. I got that. But the Minecraft, I just don't. To me, it seems so like the graphic. I'm like, dude, like, y'all like Nintendo. Like, real Nintendo graphics,
right.
Everything is square,
but it is you know, a nice piece of technology that is under all that.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Because you can fully create your own world in it and all that stuff like that. I don't know. I don't have that much patience. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The kind of games I like is like, you know, God of War, where give you an objective, they give you a whole bunch of bad guys, and you just go right
after
through
them.
It.
Uh-huh.
Exactly.
All right.
Made money off of it, actually. Like,
you made money off of Minecraft?
Microsoft bought Minecraft for $2.5 billion, and also kids started a business for like selling maps and stuff on it.
What? Look at this. Y'all hear this?
Hey, so do you know how to make
these babies?
Oh, y'all hear that? We make a little side business here.
Yeah. I'm just saying, like, it's hard to make them. These people have talent at it. Like, it's hard. For me, I just love the game. I love, like, that's one of my favorite games. That game I research about.
Wow.
Wow.
$2.5 billion. That's more than going to the moon.
Wow.
Yeah.
Listen at that, y'all.
Yeah. I got that. I don't plan on, I don't want to go to the moon. I just want the
2.5 million. Yeah, I wouldn't mind that.
Yeah, that's cool.
That's a heck of a budget.
Exactly. You know how many moves we can make with that?
I'm telling you.
So the magician thing, so like, was somebody else in the family a magician, or is it something you just came into contact you wanted to do?
I've been homeschooled my whole life, and I really just wanted to pick up girls. And that's how it started.
That's how I got filmmaking, so I got
you. Yeah, I knew a few card tricks, started going out, performing for anybody and everybody, and it just kind of, passion grew. All right,
so did you got a girlfriend yet?
Yes.
Okay, did you use the card tricks thing together? Because you got to show me how to do that real quick.
No, it was a different type of magic.
Just in case, you know, but, I got to find somebody else, you know.
I got a different type of magic for you. Go ahead. Try it out if you want to. Go ahead.
Okay. Well, hey, you know what, though? I love seeing you guys do what you do. I want to see more. Do you do shows, performances, or how can people?
I do. I am in the process of making a show unlike anything the world has ever seen before.
Okay. When can we expect that?
Nice.
After the school year.
By
summer, June.
By summer, June?
Wow.
Expect me performing everywhere. Every big event, expect me at.
Floored. That is awesome.
You know, when he talks like this, he's a very even keel type of kid. Mm-hmm. So when he talks like nobody's ever seen, he's not prone to exaggerate.
Oh, wow.
You know, so yeah, I'm excited. I don't even know what it is. I can't wait.
Well, that's what's up. Well, yeah. Hey, I look forward to seeing it. Hopefully you can come back on the show and do some magic. I mean, are you prepared to do some magic tricks tonight? I don't know.
I would if you'd like to see something.
Yes, I would like to see something, especially right. that I can learn to do.
So a common misconception about magicians
okay.
is that we play off of your stupidity. And that we're always here to fool you and deceive you.
Okay.
And that's not all magic is.
Do you play spades? First of all.
You wouldn't want to play
spades. No, I'm saying, look.
That is true.
Tell him what you always say. That you don't want to play a card game that you can't cheat at.
Yep. But
hey, look, I had a birthday party. Nah, I'm good at spades. I'm real good at spades too. But hey, if you ever want to go play some spades, make some real money. Yeah. All right, well, go ahead, show what you got.
So I don't play off stupidity because one thing is the closer you're looking, the less you'll see.
Okay.
And I play off of your intelligence, and you seem like a very intelligent man.
No, lies.
So what I'm gonna do is something that's. Looks really cool,
okay.
but it's a bit obvious.
All right.
So tell me you want me to stop.
Stop.
All right. That'll be your card. Go ahead. Take it. Don't show it to me, though.
All
right. All right. Got it? Did she see it?
Oh.
Yeah, let the camera see it. Make sure, you know, we're not set anything up.
Let the camera see it. You'll see that.
You know you can see the camera, right?
Well, he's looking the other way.
He's looking up way. All
right. There you go.
Got it back?
Mm-hmm. All
right. I'm going to just take your card. So one more time. All
right.
You can all see it?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So what we're going to do is going to take your card. Set it right there.
Mm-hmm.
Put it in the center. None of that sleight of hand crap. Mm-hmm. All right. So when I take the top card,
mm-hmm.
obviously it's not your card.
No.
Six of clubs.
No.
Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the 6 of clubs
mm-hmm.
and just get painted across the deck.
Okay.
When I paint it, the card can actually change the ink on the card. Like that.
Well, goddamn. I looked right at him.
I was looking at him. Did y'all see that?
Hey.
No sleight of hand because obviously... What you'd probably be thinking mm-hmm. is that I just switched it.
Mm-hmm.
That I just switched it in a very fast way.
Mm-hmm.
So we're not going to do that this time. So this time I'll actually place it in the center for you to see.
Okay.
All right, hold out your hand for me. Hold out your hand because this is going to happen in your hand. So then you know there's no sleight of hand.
Look at you.
3 of clubs, right?
Uh-huh. 3 of clubs.
You still see it?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to switch it. I just want you to hold it. Just like that. All
right. If this is the 7 of hearts in my hand right here, I'm going to call it Exorcist, and we're going to have you
Better call the Exorcist.
Y'all saw that?
Wait a minute. Did y'all see this?
Hey, look, I know this is...
That was not the card that was in his hand.
Hey.
That was not the card that was in his hand.
No, that was not the card that was in my hand. But you know what, though? That is amazing. I'm quite sure you get a lot of pennies.
That is amazing. All right. Wow. You slipped that one on in, didn't you?
Yeah, I know, right?
Do you do classes?
I can.
I want to learn that trick right there, because the one I know is a little bit elementary, you know.
Compared to that.
Wow. So that's good. I like that.
Kid is amazing.
You know, I seen somebody down at what is it, Atlantic Station, you know, doing those tricks. You ever been down to Atlantic Station and they have the person in the middle? You can go down there and clean up on just throwing money and tips.
That's street money.
I mean, it's still good money.
Let's go to Vegas.
You want to see something you haven't seen?
Let's go to Vegas.
You want to see something you've never seen?
Yes.
All right.
I want to see something.
I'm going to riffle down again. Tell me when to stop.
Check this out, y'all.
All right, y'all got the camera into this one? All right.
Tell me when to stop.
Bro, stop.
Right there?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, I'm not going to handle the deck. I just want you to look at your card.
All right,
I'm going to turn my back.
All right.
Now, what I want you to do is show the card to the camera. I'm holding on.
Right, I'm going to put the camera and the microphone down. All right, hold on. Y'all see that? All right.
Show it to Rodney.
Yeah, so there you we go.
See it?
Yeah,
there you go. All right. There you go.
Let testing get in
now
there.
Now that you've got it, I want you to take it, and I want you to shuffle it into the deck. Go and see it, though.
Oh, the card?
Yeah. Oh, okay. I can't find it.
He said shuffle it into the deck.
Shuffle it in.
No, I'm
not doing that. He's shuffling. Yeah.
Tell me when you're done.
Oh, shit.
He didn't already change the card.
He's already in there.
Yeah. Got it?
Hold up.
But we did put it up to the camera. Right. He's shuffling the card into the deck. Y'all, pay attention.
I did it. All right. So, I can turn?
Yeah, you can turn.
Okay. So now the card's in the center of the pack.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, I'm going to do something you haven't seen. Because every magician can go into the card deck and find cards, as you just seen.
Right.
So, I want you to take your hand. Right-handed?
Yes.
All right. I want you to take your hand. I want you to grab my wrist, just like this.
Grab your wrist, okay.
Yeah. Right there.
Mm-hmm.
Squeeze it. Squeeze it tight. Don't worry, I'm good.
I'm
tighter than you can.
I am tighter.
Tighter?
Tight. Because
what I want is for blood to stop in my veins. Because once the blood stops in my veins, kind of like squeezing a balloon, the blood will rise up to my skin. So yeah, squeeze tighter. All
right.
There you go. There
y'all
you
see
go.
This?
I don't want to hurt yourself. I'm sorry.
You're the arm. Trust. Go on.
Trust. Uh-huh.
Squeeze tighter.
I am squeezing tight. I can squeeze.
All right, let go. See those blood marks there?
Yeah.
Yeah, because you squeeze it.
Okay.
So watch. Watch those blood marks. I'm going to see if I can find your card. Look at me.
Look at you.
All right, now look at the blood marks. Watch. I'm going to
wait, what?
Watch the blood. Watch it. Really watch.
Oh. Hold up. Hold the hell up.
Watch.
If y'all can see this.
Wait.
The actual...
And trace your fingers so they can see.
Seven. Oh, diamond.
Holy... On his wrist.
Wait a minute.
The seven diamonds on his wrist. Like the indent.
Oh, that's such a good trick.
In the blood.
That's crazy.
That's sick.
That means that you did that.
No.
Which?
No.
You
Duke me.
Awesome.
Mind blowing.
Boy.
Mind blowing.
You be, look, you. Vegas is what you need to do. No, thank you. Hey, after the show, you need a manager.
What am I?
We'll talk. We'll talk. We'll smooth over it.
Listen, these kids are amazing. Did y'all see? Oh.
I know.
I am.
Now, but here's the kicker, though. The first thing he said, look, I'm not going to play on your intelligence or how dumb you are. Man, I don't know how you did that, but that was some crazy shit.
Yeah, he said, right.
I'm sorry, but that look freaky stuff right there, man.
Wow.
I'm pretty sure you got like a truckload of stuff you can do just like that.
That's
even
the tip
better.
Of the iceberg.
Yes. Well, so. I tell you what, when he's getting ready to actually launch his show and do everything that you want to do, we want to bring him back on the show.
Yes, please.
And get some, really give him some good time on here, because I think that is
and
absolutely,
you know what?
Awesome.
Tell your dad you should make a movie about magicians. Like, forget that CB Noun crap. Forget that. You look.
Yeah.
Did some video. Yeah, man, that's awesome.
That's what's up right there. Thank you. And then do a training video, too, because, you know, how to get girls with magicians. That was all about it. He got into it.
That's why
girls,
he got seven
so
kids.
I'm
always talking about getting girls.
I know how to get friend zoned, so.
You gotta get friend
zoned. You know how to get friend zoned. Hey, it's close enough. Right,
the friend zone is something Houdini could never escape from.
And he's a comedian, guys, so he's. Wow. Okay. Alright, so how long you been doing this again? How long?
5 years.
That's wow. That's
awesome.
Yeah, he's definitely awesome.
Man, you got some good things. Good genes in you, baby. Good genes in you. Good genes.
I know you got some stuff in the works for. I mean, you have to have some stuff. They're putting some stuff up and thinking. I know your wheels are turning
for
him, because that right there, I think it will be a really untapped market for.
And that's the thing. You know, you know that's the reason. That's one reason why, you know, we work so hard at what we do, is so that, you know, our kids can have that platform
mm-hmm. to launch off of that, yeah. you know, we didn't have.
No. That's right.
You
that's
see
right.
what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's you know, so I remember the other day he was just sitting there. He was just telling me all, you know, his plans. That, Dad, I look, this is what I want to do. This is my trajectory. And I was just
what?
Looking. I'm like, Jesus.
Wow. Yeah,
like, I'm sitting here talking to a young adult right here.
Yeah, well, absolutely.
You know what I'm saying?
16.
Yeah. yeah. Like, but you know.
No, I mean, his mind, is, yeah.
It kind of clicks. Like, that was a moment that it clicked. Like, oh, shit.
Right, yeah. He's actually growing up. Yeah. He's a young man. That's up, awesome. Man.
I know you can't be more proud than y'all right now. Yeah. That's amazing, right?
That
there.
Is totally it, awesome.
It's a blessing.
I'm still tripping off that.
Yeah. Well, tell us what else you guys got coming up with 480 Films. What else you have coming up?
Well, the next feature release that we have coming out is Greed.
Mm-hmm.
That's an action adventure. We've been holding on to that one for a bit.
Yeah.
You know, after that, and probably within this year as well, is 30 Day Rule.
Okay.
Which is a romantic comedy. And some other stuff that
okay.
we y'all probably going to hear about very soon.
Well, nice. I look forward soon. To it. I look forward to that right there. I guess we want to talk about some other things too. Some more real serious stuff right here.
Right.
We're done with magician stuff right now. All
right, just so, for a little bit.
Just a little bit.
That was awesome.
I'll come back later on with that.
Man, that was
all
awesome.
All right, so now a lot of people who probably looking at this thing who know the whole TPN and 480 history.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There is no beef.
Yes.
There is no beef.
None.
There has been people in both our circles trying to arrange something that wasn't there. Now I admit I took partake in listening to.
No.
What's the word?
Try it again.
What's the word?
No.
First of all, you got my English teacher, okay?
Okay.
Y'all know what I'm talking about. Anyway, people will try to put us against one another,
yeah.
which we're not. Mm-hmm. And people don't realize, when that whole stuff was going on, me and Rodney had a relationship. We was talking just about every other week on Facebook.
Yep.
So when people start saying stuff, I was like, why? What's going on?
Right.
And then that kind of made me step back and made them step back.
Mm-hmm.
But I want people to understand that there was never nothing personal against 480 on TPN side, and there was nothing
never
on 480 side against TPN side.
Definitely.
We're two individual film companies who actually do good work.
Yeah. Yep.
And we also respect one another. And I'm gonna put a little history out there too. Tavares is actually one of the one of the judges who actually judged the TPN Film Awards.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Nobody don't know that, you know what I'm saying?
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know, so because he's a type person, he don't talk a lot, he don't put out there like that. Mm-hmm. So I just want you guys to help me out here. You know what I'm saying? How people will try to change and put people against one another for the sake of their own insecurities.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Yep.
And that's what it's all was about. Exactly. Their own insecurities, and they try to put it on us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I just hate that we wasted so many years of that.
Right.
We could have came together a long time ago.
It's you know, one of the key things that you learn is that, and especially in this business, in any business, mm-hmm. you have to have the right people around.
Yeah.
That's right.
You know. And until you have the right people around you, you won't be able to reach your full potential.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, there is, you know, you tend to sometimes keep negative people around you because you're worried that you're not going to be able to attract anybody else,
mm-hmm.
you know, especially when you're starting out or you're in the growing process.
Mm-hmm.
And unfortunately, you know, that gets us in a situation where we sometimes keep around people that we knew in our heart that we shouldn't have.
And that's exactly how it was on our side, you know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? And I just wanted people to understand that there was never any animosity towards 480 whatsoever, you know what I'm saying? I was at pivotal moment in your life. We was there,
right.
You know what I'm saying? And I just want people to understand, like, you know, I have no beef with a lot of different people. Only thing about me, I'm a very outspoken person.
Mm-hmm.
Very.
You know, and I'm a very free-hearted person, you know what I'm saying?
Very.
I say what's on my mind. And yes. I say some people take that as, okay, what's the word?
Cockiness, maybe.
Cockiness.
Right.
Yeah.
You know what
mm-hmm.
I'm saying? But I'm happy with what I do.
Right.
I'm proud of what I do. So if I can't say, hey, look, I made a movie today. If I can't tell the world that, then why did I make the movie?
Right. Exactly.
You know what
exactly.
I'm saying? So, and that's what happens. People, they get so stuck in, well, shit, I'm going to try to make this movie for 3 hours, 3 days, and or 3 years, whatever, and they still can't get it done. And we done like 10 mm-hmm. movies in that time span.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Or they still trying to get that idea off the ground, and we done plenty of that time span.
Right.
It's not a race.
It really is.
It's not a race. Mm-mm. What works for that particular people, that's work for them.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I had to just cut out a lot of negative people.
Yeah.
You know,
absolutely.
Who try to, you know, put bad water, you know, into the sauce.
Man, but that's the industry, man. And
yeah.
Unfortunately, that's more of the case than not.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in this business. The thing is that because of my nature, mm-hmm. you know, I do have a very giving and caring nature, and that doesn't exactly bode well for this industry.
No. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? That's why, you know, T shielded me from a lot of that gaga mm-hmm. that goes on.
He does.
Because, you know, it throws me out of my creative space.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But you know, it is what it is, man. You know, we hear stuff, you know, all the time, you know, oh, 480 takes too long getting stuff out and all that stuff like that.
No.
And it's like, you know what? Yeah, everything happens for a reason.
Right.
And it's good stuff.
You're not putting out trash.
It's not putting out trash. Yeah. And I like people to understand that. You know what I'm saying? Y'all not racing it. Who y'all competition is yourself.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Only thing I really hate about the whole situation, because it was years.
Yeah.
Is that we never had a chance to collaborate on anything. That's my only. Because it's plenty of times that, oh man, I'd love to have him on this project. Oh man, I wish I could have been on that project. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right.
So that's my only
yeah.
regret is
yeah.
that I wish that we could have collaborated years ago.
Yeah.
But we are where we are now. But I'm glad we could have done that years ago. I think both companies would probably been even further than what we are right now.
Right.
Because I think the resources that we both have on our own, sharing them and nurturing each other,
right.
I think we would have accomplished a lot.
I agree.
And
you
building
know?
Relationships,
yeah.
and we're
kind of guilty of that because again, we do stay very to ourselves, and people take that as a negative sometimes, and it's not that. It's just, man, you know, like I said, we've been through a lot.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We've been through a lot, and we're very focused on work.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so. You know, yeah, we don't do the mixers a whole lot. Like when you see us out in public,
yeah.
it's like I told you before, when we went to the taboo screening,
mm-hmm.
like yeah, not too much gets me out of the house.
Yeah, mm-hmm. exactly.
You
know?
That's where I come in.
Yeah, 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 yeah. That's certainly where
there's
she come in.
To do, let's go.
Yeah,
let's go.
I respect that too, because I know I'm like
if whatever
we're doing to get Rodney out the house. That means that's love and respect, right? That's
right.
all day
yeah.
long. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So I appreciate that.
Yeah,
I do want to
yeah.
touch on you and Tavares' relationship. I see how Tavares is very passionate about you
mm-hmm.
as his friend and his brother. And you know, your brother in the industry, of course, but as his friend and brother.
No, yeah, yeah.
You
it
know,
goes,
and
it goes beyond the
right,
industry.
Beyond the industry, right. And I love that, you know, regardless of whatever situations with us. I remember watching Tavares on one of his live videos, and something must have happened, but Mr. Tavares was going in and it was on your behalf.
Yeah.
And I was like, look at that.
Yeah.
You know, that's love. That's your brother. You know what I'm saying? That's brotherhood, and that's how it's supposed to be.
Right.
You know, especially you're going to protect each other.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, my husband, I know he's very giving and free-hearted. I shield him
yeah.
sometime. I have to, you know, come in and be like, oh, no, we're going to cut that down. We're shutting it down right now, you know.
Right.
But because we have to balance each other out.
Exactly.
You
exactly.
know. So that's how I think you and Tavares is. And I really respect that
yeah.
wholeheartedly.
I think so. That's
yeah.
good. That's nurturing right there, man.
Mm-hmm.
It shows in the work.
Yeah.
yeah.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? Look. Y'all don't understand. This movie they got coming out. I don't want to say the name.
All
right. I want to say the name. But the movie they got
oh,
coming
yeah.
out, though, that I was actually it. In.
Yes. Yes.
Hey,
yes.
look. all I'm gonna say, all the other film companies out there who got their own little insecurity beef, y'all ain't seen nothing yet, because what these guys are doing,
yes, absolutely, is
gonna take the whole Atlanta industry to a whole new level, and I love it.
That's
and
right.
I love it for the fact is that I can sit back and watch it. I've seen it from the start to where it is now,
that's
and
right.
I see that. It's oh, I had a conversation up to a distributor about you guys. I don't know if he told you.
Oh yeah. He and it was, it's so funny because he was like, yeah, he was like, you know, Bobby told us that y'all were one of the best in Atlanta years ago. Mm-hmm. And
wow,
that,
so look at that.
Yeah, and that was like, you yeah. know, once again, you know, that just shows you what kind of character that you have.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know, and you know, I don't want to, you know, broach on the BS that was mm-hmm. out there, but needless to say, you know, of course, you know, y'all being at Susan's funeral, that was, you know,
yeah.
amazing.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. So, I said,
we used to talk
yeah.
about that situation before you even went to it. You
before,
know what I'm saying? You know,
right.
I would ask you, hey, how's it going? Because I had the same situation. You know,
right,
what I'm saying?
Right.
So I understood where you're coming from. So yeah. I'm like, and whatever the film stuff is gone, he's still a man.
Yeah.
We're gonna talk.
We're gonna
rap. So,
yeah.
I mean, I appreciate, you know, the love that you guys have shown me, but I don't lie when I say y'all are 480s is one of the best.
Yeah.
In Atlanta right now, and probably gonna be beyond Atlanta in a couple of weeks.
Yep.
In a couple of weeks.
It's something brewing.
And I know Tavares got some ideas, and I know the man, because we've rapped and talked to some things too on collaboration project, and the way this guy thinks,
yeah.
he's a visionary. Yeah. And I told him, he is a true
yeah.
visionary in every sense of the word.
He is mm-hmm. He's on a whole new plateau. I mean, of ideas and concepts. I mean, because I've read some stuff that he had. I'm like, dude, like, come on, like, who thinks of this shit, man?
Yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
Like, you know what
yeah.
I'm saying? And but the thing about it, he had a love and passion to actually get it done.
Yep.
You know, I've seen people
by
who have that same
necessary.
Love.
Yeah.
He can get it done.
It's like the one thing that Tavares, you know, taught me, because I think in a lot of filmmakers that go through formal
mm-hmm.
you know training, they
mm-hmm.
go to school and everything, the first thing they're like is, all right, now I need somebody to help me pay for this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I need to go and get investors and you know, pray that the big investor in the sky come down
mm-hmm.
and bless me with some funds
to
make a movie.
Mm-hmm.
And Tavares is that one person. He's like, Roy, we gonna do this.
We gonna do it regardless.
By hook or by crook.
Yeah.
That's
and
right.
Because I'm more of the analytical one. You know, maybe we can do this. You know, like, but it's a balance.
It's a yeah. balance.
It's a
there.
Balance because mm-hmm. he gets me to the point where he's just like, look, man, we just gonna have to fly by our seat
mm-hmm.
our pants on this one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I'm like, shoot, look, if he's that confident in us.
Let's do it.
Well, listen, tell us, I know our time is winding down. Just tell us where we can, or anybody can reach you. Facebook, if you have Instagram, wherever.
Okay. All right. My social media is all over the place. So, all right, my Facebook is, Rodney Jackson 77. You know, you put in facebook.com/RodneyJackson77. I do most of my social media on Facebook because, mm-hmm. like, I'm an old man, I guess. So I don't understand. I got Twitter, but the whole Twitter thing and hashtags and stuff. But I do have Twitter. It's r.o.d. And Instagram is ECRE Gold, which that has a little story that goes behind
okay.
it. I dubbed myself as the East Coast RE Gold at one time because
okay.
I love Entourage and I wanted to be like RE Gold when I came in.
Throwing computers out the windows and whatnot.
Well, look, only if I could afford to replace it.
Alright, and young man, you want Instagram? What
my
do you
Instagram
got?
Is Elijah J. Jackson. ELIJAH J. Jackson.
Alright. All y'all cougars out there, he is taken. All right, I know y'all, you know. All right, and...
Oh, It's just Facebook, although I've been meaning to open up an Instagram as part of my like New Year's resolution for 2017.
Well, this is Martin now. We're gonna get it done.
And it's just Erica Sutherland, so you can see me in our Focus Gear Red Hat. Part of my homepage, so
awesome.
And we got the friend zone kid here.
All right, I don't really post that much on social media. Like after school year, probably yes, I might start posting.
Okay.
But Fantasy Wolfpack, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and subscribe to me on YouTube. And finish it, Daddy. This is what we do.
All right, guys.
Awesome.
We appreciate Rodney Jackson and the family here.
Yes.
We're going to cut to the commercial, and we'll be back with our next guest, Rasheda Randle. So, Rasheda, you guys, we'll see you back in a few.
Peace out.
This is Marissa from Sultry Solutions, and you're tuning in to TPN Live with Bobby and Renee Peoples on Instant Radio. Enjoy.
Hey, y'all. Have you heard the news? Oh my goodness, Instant Radio now has TPN Live with Renee and Bobby Peoples. Attention writers, directors, movie makers, actors, everyone, come join them. It will be, when is it? The first and third Thursday of every month from 8 to 10 p.m. Live, y'all!
No wasting time at all, we're so phenomenal.
Different flavors make the world go around. And now try the flavor of hot honey mustard on the boneless wings meal. Served with crinkle fries, Texas toast, and a 22-ounce drink. Friends, family, flavor. Zaxby's, indescribably good.
Honey, wonder if your wife knows you're here right now.
Your dad plays professional football, right?
Tell us a little bit about the movie.
Hello, indie fans. Today I'm here with Eduardo Castrillo, the filmmaker.
Home to the best indie movies.
Hey, what up? It's your boy Lim Collins here to remind y'all to tune in to TPN Live with my family, Bobby and Renee Peoples. Get ready.
Station in the world playing all of today's hits. You're listening to Instinct Radio.
You gotta do it again.
Hey, welcome back.
We had a great first interview with my homeboys from 480, Rodney Jackson and the family.
Yes.
And as y'all can see right now, we have the lovely, talented, off the world tour, Miss Rasheda Randle's in the house.
Yes, Miss Rasheda.
And that trailer we just finished watching, that was actually an older trailer because for her premiere, that was last year actually, so that's my fault. I'm going to take the blame for that today.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to take the blame for that today, but you know, right, she didn't know. No, I was messing with you.
But you got the gist of it. That movie is hot.
Yes.
Thank
you. We went to the screening for that. And
it was a good movie, really good movie.
Yes.
But you just went to the film festival with that movie, right?
Yes, I went to the Hollywood Black Film Festival
in
LA.
How was that?
It was amazing. The film was very well received.
Okay.
We made some really good connections. I need a booster seat. I feel like I'm so short. But no, we made some really good connections, put the film in some hands of some pretty big producers.
Okay.
So,
nice.
Yeah, it was nice. Really, really good.
It was a really good movie, so,
Before we go into that, let her introduce yourself to those of you, those that may not know who you are, and tell them a little bit about yourself.
Okay, well, my name is Rasheda Randle. I'm an actress and also a filmmaker. I write, direct, produce. I like to say a content creator. I'm originally from Indianapolis, Indiana. I've been in Atlanta for 2 years. I came here to further my career, and so far it's definitely been the right move.
Okay.
All right. All right.
What made you move to Atlanta besides furthering your career? Like, what was it that made you say, you know what? That's it, I'm out.
It was God.
Okay.
I felt like I had exhausted all of my resources in Indianapolis, and I wanted to go to L.A. I really wanted to go to L.A., but every time I tried to work it out to go that way, God would redirect me down here. Mm. I would get an audition here, or I would book something here, or an agent would reach out to me here. It was always something that kept leading me to Atlanta, and I said, you know what, let me be obedient. Mm-hmm. And let me follow what he's telling me to do and trust him and go and just give it a chance. And I think that it was probably the best thing for me to do at the time where I was in my career. Because no matter how good people think I am, if I wasn't secure enough to go to LA, I didn't want to fall on my face.
Gotcha.
When I got there. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. Had a list of things I wanted to accomplish when I came to Atlanta before I make that jump to the West Coast.
And you've been to the West Coast, you pretty much bi-coastal right now.
Yeah. Oh, I love that word.
Yes, you're bi-coastal because you're in and out, you're doing a lot of work. You've made leeway being here for 2 years in Atlanta. I mean, you've made a lot of noise here in Atlanta, Georgia. Right. So, I mean, we're excited to know you and to have worked with you.
Yes, finally.
Yeah.
Because you're so busy.
No, Bobby, don't you start that. We're not going to start that today, yes. Bobby, because you know that anytime you guys need me or want me, just call me. I am there.
But then I look at it like, damn, she's so busy. Like, I don't want to take away from that. But
what did I tell you on set last time? Yeah, you make time for the things that you want to do.
That's true. But she's always busy, though.
She be out. When I looked up, I was like, okay, she's in Cali. You know, I follow her Facebook. Oh, she's in Cali. I see her. You know, she went there for the film festival. Then I turned around. I'm like, she's in Paris? Like, when did that happen? You was just in California. Then you came home, and then you were right out again.
It was literally like within 6 days.
Wow.
It must be nice.
Yes.
It must be nice. We want to be like you when we get older.
I know. Your job is just very flexible. I mean, you can just up and go. I mean, tell us a little bit about that.
Work as a contractor. Mm-hmm. I didn't want to get a full-time permanent job when I came here because I wanted my focus to be acting. I didn't want to do anything that I would be fulfilled at. I hope nobody from my job is watching this. But no, they don't really know this side of my life.
That's right. You know, I try to keep it separate.
I definitely have to keep it separate because I've been in a position where I've been burned that way before when I've been open about what I'm doing. Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's a very flexible job because, like I said, it is a contract job, so I'm really not obligated to work 40 hours a week, you know? And they pretty much let me off when
you get ready.
Problem is, you don't work, you don't get paid.
That's right.
So. You don't eat, so that's true.
Right.
Okay.
I get that. So what made you do this story what my dad should have told me?
Okay, so things my daddy should have told me just kind of, that's okay, everybody mess it up. I'll let you slide now.
See how she slid that in.
Yeah, right.
Well, it's a script that I started in 2012.
Okay.
And I just never really went back to it. I think I wrote the second scene, and I never touched it again. And then I met one of the young ladies who is one of the lead actresses in the film, and she's like, you know, you write. Come on, write something for us so we can work together. So originally I wrote it as a means for actors to work and to work together.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And so that's why you see everyone in the film is so – it's an organic – chemistry between everyone that's in the film.
Mm-hmm.
And so that was originally why I did the film, and then also just to kind of test it out
and
see what the reception would be from people. And And it's been amazing so far. Mm-hmm. But it wasn't really based off of anything. There are parts of me in it and mm-hmm. parts of other people's experiences that I know of. And mm-hmm. But, I mean, it wasn't like, you know, something traumatic happened to me that, inspired it. Just, okay. Yeah.
So what do you like more? You like directing more or acting more? Like, if you had to choose between the one, what would you do?
I would definitely act.
Why is that?
If I had to choose, because that's what my passion is. Mm-hmm. I tell people all the time, I'm an actress first. It just so happens that I have the ability and the resources and the talent to be able to create the content that's going to not only keep me working, but it's also going to give work to other actors as well. So if I had to choose, it would definitely be acting.
So you've done a lot of stuff here in Atlanta, I've seen. And but you also tons done some network stuff, like on Fox.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
it's a show coming out on Fox that you a part of.
Mm-hmm. March 22nd,
and I know you really can't go into detail about how that actually goes into play, but tell us a little bit what you can about what's happening on March 22nd.
Okay, so March 22nd is the world premiere of Shots Fired.
Shots Fired.
On Fox. I think it's after the Empire premiere. Mm-hmm. And it stars Sanaa Lathan, Richard Dreyfuss, Helen Hunt, Mac Wiles, Stephon James, and Stephen Moyer.
Okay.
And it's just about a black officer who shoots and kills an unarmed white teen in a predominantly black neighborhood.
Ouch.
And the police department is corrupt, and they try to cover it up. And so they call in these two detectives from the Justice Department to come and investigate the police.
Mm-hmm.
I play one of the witnesses who actually saw everything happen, but knowing how the police department is, we don't want to talk to the police. So I give them a bit of pushback, even though they, you know, it's Sanaa Lathan and Stephon James are the two detectives, and they're saying we're not investigating. We're investigating the police, so we're here on your side. I'm like, I ain't trying to hear that.
About it, right.
I ain't seen nothing.
So this is a reoccurring role then for you?
Originally it was, but some of the scenes got cut, which happens.
Yeah, right.
It's fine, you know, so I got that check.
That's right.
Let's go to the trailer, and let's put that trailer of Shots Fire trailer on and see what we're looking like here, all right?
Yeah, that's exciting.
Get on the ground.
There's been a police shooting of an unarmed man today.
Governor called personally. She doesn't want another Ferguson.
All I care about is the truth. And my truth has no color.
I have assurances from the department. You'll have their full cooperation. I'm not a fan of surprises, so I'd appreciate being kept up to speed.
I read your report. I just want to hear it from you.
I asked him to step out of the vehicle. But as he steps out, he rushes for my gun. Gets a hand on it. And in that moment, it was either him or me. And I shot him.
4 times.
Yes, he continued to struggle.
The officer said he went for his gun.
Jesse would never do that.
Y'all ain't see nothing or hear nothing?
Look, we're not police. We're investigating police.
No one's got answers for you. You keep asking the wrong question.
So what's the right question?
You need to go ask Miss Campbell.
What do you know about the white kid who was just killed by the cop?
Why would I know anything about that?
We were told to ask you the question.
Well, I don't know why he said that.
When did you lose your son?
Can't talk about it.
Who told you that? The police? The department is obviously corrupt.
Officials say the racist remarks are from Joshua Beck, an African-American deputy.
Just graduated from the academy. Any last words?
Finally got my license to shoot these crackers. Crackers. Crackers.
We have got to start putting each other's humanity first. None of us will like the America we end up with if we don't start working very hard at this.
Just as long as you believe that you can win, it's from within.
No one is above the law. And when there are questions, I want answers.
But all these people, they just want to see you fall. And they don't know that you can take it all.
My son is dead.
We're very sorry for your loss.
I didn't lose him. He was murdered.
All the murdering of unarmed black men by police across this country. And this is the one that the government is investigating.
All these people, they just want to see you fall. They don't know how much that you can fall. Show the world you can take it all. Take it all.
Tell a friend to tell a friend. Download the app on Google Play, Instinct Radio, or go to instinctradio.net. And now, back to the hottest sounds around. Instinct Radio.
I cannot.
I saw you in the trailer, too.
Twice.
So, look, so that means y'all better check it out because she's in that.
That's right.
Yes. She's not just one of these extras out here saying, you know, I was in this movie here and we saw her like in the crowd somewhere. You know,
That's right. She's actually in it with lines.
Yes. So that's so awesome. Funny because the extras that day were looking at me like, who are you?
Right.
One of them actually asked me, are you somebody?
Really?
You should say, yeah, I'm my mama's child.
Because they were seeing like makeup and wardrobe coming over and touching me up and, you know, PAs giving me water and stuff. And they were like, who are you supposed to be?
Wow.
They just don't know.
Wow. Look at
they don't know. You are that girl.
That's right.
We all know that girl. So I know Renee want to talk to you about, other than the movie stuff you got going on, I know she want to talk about your life.
Y'all know I want to hear about this trip. And I'm sure everybody out there, listen, like I said, honey girl.
Baby, I mean, girl, not too many people get to twerk in front of Buckingham Palace.
Yes!
She's twerking in front of Buckingham Palace, you know.
She was like, yo, trip. Listen, it ain't no trip until you twerk in front of Buckingham Palace.
That's right.
So that was awesome. Tell us about your trip. What made you, what took you out there?
Oh, it was amazing. So my little cousin turned 30. I got to stop calling her little cousin. But
Yeah, she got to be big cousin.
Right.
So she turned 30, and my family is really close, and we always take trips together. And so all of the cousins this time just decided to just go on a European vacation. And so we started in Paris. One of my cousins broke her arm. She broke her shoulder like as soon as we got there. But that didn't stop her.
Really?
We still had a good time. We spent the first day in the emergency room. We went on a dinner cruise. So Paris was my least favorite.
Really?
Okay.
Yeah, it was my least favorite. I don't know, it's a very beautiful city, but it compared to Amsterdam and London, which were our second and third stops,
mm-hmm.
it just didn't compare to me. And I don't know, the people were kind of rude, too.
Really?
Yeah, people were kind of rude. So then we took the train to Amsterdam, and that was an experience itself. That was my favorite.
How long was it to get there?
The train ride was only like, I don't know, maybe 45 minutes. Okay. No. I'm telling a lie. The train ride was like 3 hours.
Okay.
The flight from Amsterdam to London was only like 45 minutes.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah, so So Amsterdam was fun. Everybody is real cool, nice, and chill because they're all high.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad you said that because your trip made this person over here go get our passport pictures taken.
Yes!
But that's not the kicker. I'm telling you what the kicker is. So we're going to register our passport, I guess, to go apply for it on April the 20th.
On 4/20. I don't know what he's talking about.
Just so you put it out there.
I got it.
So she like, we go to Amsterdam. Babe.
I inboxed her from Amsterdam.
Right.
I saw the pictures.
We are going to Amsterdam. I don't care. We will be there.
Just keep Bobby out of the red light district.
Okay.
That's where I'm going. I'm going straight to
the red light. Is it a lot of little people in there? Or, I mean, what? What? Like midgets?
So, no. Prostitution is legal.
Oh, yeah. It's legal in Amsterdam.
Prostitution is legal. And so the girls are in the windows. And they're trying to get you to come in. They have live shows. Use your imagination.
Wow.
We're going to Amsterdam.
I want to go to Amsterdam. I ain't worried about it.
They got museums and everything. It's definitely a free
country. I remember when I worked for Northwest Airlines, and I was a reservation agent, so we booked a lot of trips there.
Mm-hmm.
And I would hear how people would be so excited just when they called in to book their tickets to go to Amsterdam. It was like, it's just a free place.
It is.
You free to be who you are.
I think that's why it's my favorite, because there's like no judgment whatsoever. Like, you can walk down the street and smoke. I mean, I've seen several men coming out of those windows.
Wow.
And those gentlemen clubs and stuff like that. And there's just no judgment. I mean, it is a shock. Like, if it's your first time seeing it in, you know, live, you're like, whoa.
Right,
but
right.
You're like, hey.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
Like it. Right.
Right.
And London was great. I would live in London.
Mm-hmm.
I would definitely live in London. It reminds me of New York City.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
She's never been to New York.
See, I've never been to New York, so I can't wait. So, yeah, that's another place we're going to go. But, so... So what was London like? I've seen a lot of the pictures in London too, and it looked amazing. Mm-hmm.
Again, it's a very beautiful city. Mm-hmm. The building structures are amazing. And it's so rich with history. But there's just so much to see and so much to do. And we did a lot of foot sightseeing.
Mm.
But the people there are friendly, and everybody over in Europe dislikes our president.
Wow.
Well,
different
here.
Wow.
They can barely speak English and French or in Paris, and they're asking me, what's up with your president?
Oh my gosh.
But,
that's embarrassing.
That is kind of embarrassing.
Embarrassing.
But yeah, London is great. London is the food is good. I think the food was probably better in probably in London.
Really?
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, but wow. It was, I definitely had an amazing, amazing time. And people travel, go see the world. It is not as expensive as you think.
Yeah, see, that's what I was going to get with you on, too, just to see, you know, like where you stayed. Because we're pretty much going to follow in your footsteps because
you
I don't
everything.
Know. I don't I'll know where to go.
You.
I just know I want to be up in
all I know is tell Rasheda about the Airbnb incident when we went to L.A. the first time.
Rasheda, you remember because we were there at the
and
same
I
time.
And I had an Airbnb incident at
the same
time.
Same incident. Y'all, we went to this Airbnb. Let me tell you. First of all, let me just put this out here. I'm from Detroit, okay? I'm from the hood.
I can't
Detroit.
Tell the way she jumped
not,
that night.
You know, I'm not new to the hood, okay? But when we got there, y'all... I was like, wait a minute, hold up, where are we at? Because I'm not used, this is my first time in California, I don't know the area.
Right.
To me, it didn't look good. I was like, babe, I ain't feeling this. So we get into the apartment, had to walk through this alleyway and get to the apartment.
Me too.
And I was like, you have got to be kidding me.
It was American Horror Story.
Oh my gosh.
Mine was American Horror Story.
I say, what? So then we... First of all, when I seen the pink towels, the hot pink towels on the bed for us to wash up with, I said, first of all, you can't bleach pink. These towels are here. It's pink. It's bright pink. No, I'm not using those towels. I said, babe, I'm not using these towels. I got instantly online and started looking for us a hotel. I was like, I'm not staying here after tonight. So we laid in the bed on top of the covers with all of our clothes on. So I had a water bottle. He tried it. He tried it. It was a water bottle in the window. And some kind of, it was frozen.
It was frozen,
or something.
So it melted at some point. And it melted, it fell over. Because the way the bed was set up, the bed is right next to the window. So you can pretty much walk past the window and look and see the bed.
Uh-huh.
She thought something would come through the damn window.
Baby, look, when I tell you, I like to took Bobby head off trying to get from. I said, this is
You ever seen a cat jump when it gets scared?
Yeah.
That times 10.
I was like, I can't take it.
Lord,
I can't take
y'all
it.
Y'all did
about
better than
your
me.
Story,
y'all did better than me because I didn't stay. I know as soon as I got in there, I saw that I had to go through an alley. That was strike number one.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to stand there and punch this code in this big metal door. So I'm in this alley. I got all the time in the world for the killer to come and chop my head off. Then I had to walk up these old stairs that looked like I was going to fall through them.
Oh, no.
Go into the building, punch in another code. It's a shared apartment complex or building or whatever. The room was tiny. It smelled. There was little blonde hairs all over the bed.
Oh my god.
The bed was about 3 inches off the ground.
Oh damn.
And the bathroom was nasty. And mind you, it was a shared one. So I don't know who is staying in these other apartments, which is just rooms. You know, it can be an axe murderer. Like, I can't get up and go to the bathroom in the middle of the night. Who's going to be standing on the other side of that? So, I couldn't do it. I left. I stayed with a friend that night, and I found a hotel the next day.
Yeah. That's what I'm... Did they give you your money back?
Yeah, they did give me my money back. Not... Airbnb did, because it was my first time booking with them, but the owner would not give me my money back.
Wow. Yeah, we ended up getting our money back, too, because I couldn't do it. And so we're looking now. We're going to stay a week.
We're doing another Airbnb.
But I was like, babe, we're going to do some research. We're going to have to find out about the area.
Yeah.
It's just because that was just ridiculous. Going to a new state, you don't know, you know, what you're walking into. And then you got me walking down an alley.
Right.
That's a fight for
around a corner in the dark.
Well, at least she had you there with her.
Had nobody.
I'm easy target.
See, our situation is someone got to tell her story. So if the killer come, I'm gone.
You're talking about somebody got to tell my story. I don't need nobody to tell my story.
Was a good woman. She was nice.
Bobby, that is terrible.
See,
but somebody got to tell the story.
I don't need him to tell
and
my
I'm
story.
I'm good at telling stories, so I figured it's either her or me. I mean, who would you like to tell the story? The Bryson? Would you want to break the news to Bryson that I'm gone?
I can. I know how to tell that story very well.
I tell Bryson, Bryson, your mom's gone.
I can tell that story.
Oh, my God.
No, and see, this is why. But see, the thing about it, and then I carry, I have my CCW.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't bring it with me.
You couldn't get on the plane
with that. So I felt unarmed. I felt, you know what I'm saying? I just felt like we were just in this vulnerable state. And I didn't like that feeling.
Right.
Whatsoever.
Yeah, me neither.
Whatsoever.
But
so.
We had fun in L.A., though.
Yeah, man, after that
because your birthday, man, yeah. Oh, my God. That was.
Oh, yeah, we had a lot of fun.
Birthday in L.A., man.
Yes. We shut the place down. We shut the place down.
I'm afraid I'm karaoke in.
Yeah.
Because the word karaoke does not make sense, man. You have to be karaoke in.
That's the way it should be.
We're starting doing karaoke. There you go.
Right.
So you got to do something. So. We shut that spot down. It was so fun.
Yeah,
that was the first time.
Thank y'all so much for coming out. That was so fun.
That was the crazy part because we didn't know she was going to be in California, but not only was she in California, she was also in Vegas.
In Vegas the same time. We did the same trip.
We tried to link up in Vegas. We couldn't link up. So we were like, all right, we just catch you in L.A.
Yeah.
And lo and behold.
The rest is history.
Yeah.
And
we shot scenes to our web series in L.A. while she was out
there.
Yes, that was dope. Yes. That was dope.
The
that was
part.
Awesome.
I'm like, we were not there the vacation. We said, you know what?
Let's go ahead and get it. Yeah, let's do it. Something. Let's get it.
That's how I like it. Yep. Let's go. So let's
we shot it. A scene with all the stuff in California was shot on this phone right here. Just
wait
y'all
to and it looks amazing.
Yes.
So
yes.
We want y'all to know that's how that went down.
Mm-hmm.
So, what's next for Rasheda?
Yes.
So Things My Daddy Should Have Told Me is going to Houston next for the National Black Film Festival.
Nice.
So we screen April 8th at 3:30 p.m.
Okay. You going to Texas? Are you going?
Of course.
Of course. And then I will be honored with the Artist of Influence Award at the Peach Theater Awards, which is on a cruise to Jamaica.
Wow.
In August. And nice. I have another short film that I'm doing called Second Chances that we are currently in production.
Okay. Nice. Who's in it?
Myself and Sean Baker.
Okay.
Who was also in Things My Daddy Should Have Told Me. Neil Carr, who's from Saints and Sinners.
Okay.
And Nadine Bone, Nakia Lawrence, Telly Smith. Who else? Sherry McCray is in it. Yeah, that's it.
Is this something you wrote or?
Brandon Barry. Brandon Barry's in it as well. Yes, I wrote it.
Okay.
I wrote it, and Shanice Williamson is directing it.
Okay.
Nice.
So, can you tell us about it?
Okay. So, let me try to find a short version.
Yeah.
The main character David, which is played by Sean Baker, was sent to prison in his youth for involuntary manslaughter. 10 years later, he emerges from prison and he happens to run into his sister's best friend, who is a successful book publisher. She invites him to come and stay with her, just to help him get on her feet, on his feet. But she has a fiance named Tristan, which is played by Neil Carr. And you know, once you get out of prison, you kind of have that stigma.
Mm-hmm.
That you're a criminal.
I get all the time.
Whether it was involuntary manslaughter, so he didn't mean
to do it,
but I mean it's the way that it happened. So you have that stigma, and then so her fiance Tristan is constantly like nagging at him, like he's holding that over his head. So when she brings him to stay with her, there's kind of that tension between those two.
Mm-hmm. Sexual tension.
All kinds of tension.
Okay.
It's all kinds of tension. Just two men living in the household. But see, she doesn't think that she's doing anything wrong because this is her best friend who was deceased.
Right.
Her brother. Mm-hmm. And she, you know, is just trying to help him. But her fiance sees it differently. And so, you know, things start to get a little bit heated. And
that sounds good. Yeah.
You're a brilliant writer.
Yes, you are.
Thank you.
Very, very brilliant.
Yes, absolutely.
I like the parallel stories and the twists and turns and all that good stuff. So.
Well, you the bomb. Bomb.com.
Yeah.
So other than that, so you got that going on. Is anything that we could be looking for on television or soon and features or anything?
Right now I'm just auditioning.
Okay.
I'm just auditioning and, you know, hoping for the next big role.
Okay. How did the audition you came by the house? How did that go? Remember you came by the house that time?
I didn't get it. I didn't book it, but
it was good though. You did good.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. But, you know, I submit and forget. That's what I always say. That's what I live by. You know, whenever I audition, I don't dwell on it. And I do what I perceive to be the best job that I can do. Send it off. And then it's up. Yep. So it's out of my hands.
If there was someone like who wants to get into acting or do what you do, what would be your advice to that person?
I would say that to be an actor, you have to have faith, humility, perseverance, patience, and discipline. That's what I tell everyone who wants to get into this business. It is a very difficult journey, but it is also a very rewarding one. And that's also the same for if you want to be a filmmaker. You know, you got to believe in yourself, because if you don't believe in you, then who else will?
That's right.
And you got to remain humble at all times, because no matter how great you think you are, there's always going to be somebody that is greater than you. And that can get you knocked off of your pedestal really fast. This business will humble the heck out of you. And with that, you have to have thick skin, because there's so much rejection that comes with it. Definitely. So don't quit, stick with it.
When you direct, and I don't know if you get the same kind of stuff that we get, when you put your auditions out there and people submit, like, do you do like a specific way that you want them to submit to you, or how is that process for you when actors want to submit to your projects?
Here lately, I've kind of just been casting just based off of people who I know, whose work I'm familiar with, or I'll create a character around that person.
Okay.
But when I do have auditions, or when I do, when I am looking for people to submit to me, I just ask, you know, just to email me your headshots and your resumes. And then most likely I'm not going to do an in-person audition. I'll probably have you do a video submission.
Mm-hmm.
Or sometimes if I'm being really lazy, I'll just say, send me a clip or something. It kind of depends on the urgency, okay, with the project. You know, if I just need somebody really quickly, or if I'm really taking my time and casting it.
Because what properly. We do, what we get, because like some, I'll put out a specific, you know, thing that we're looking for,
mm-hmm,
and how to do it. And 9 out of 10, no one reads the instructions and they do it, you know, their own way. And then they realize, well, I never called them back for that job, even though they might have been good at what they do.
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel about this? Like me, I say the audition process starts in the casting process. You know what I'm saying? Basically, when you submit, yep, you actually audition. As soon as you submit whatever they're asking for, that's when you're auditioning.
Because the point in that is to see if you can take direction.
Right.
That's right.
And paying attention.
And a lot of people don't look at that as, you know, as a situation. I mean, they just skim through whatever it is and like, okay, I'm going to send a reel. An audition I did for this project back 10 years ago.
Right.
And I'm like, okay, because me personally, I would sit there and put the size up. You can download it. I've had like 10 people on this last project submit video auditions of stuff that they already auditioned for somebody else. I'm like, download the whole thing. And it frustrates the hell out of me, you know, because I'm like, these are some really good actors. I've seen their work, but I'm like, you just don't read it.
You couldn't even follow this simple directions. How am I supposed to feel confident in directing you?
Yeah, and I get it. That's the thing, you know what I'm saying? But I don't want people to think that I'm just being this person. Because now I just delete it. Because most of the time Renee does the casting, but I get the emails because she don't take the emails.
Yeah. So, and most casting directors do that.
Yeah.
Anyway.
So I just delete. I'm like, she don't even like, nobody submitted. I'm like, well, no, nobody submitted. I
don't
delete.
I don't like that.
Because I would watch it. Wait a minute. And he done doggone deleted all the doggone.
Yeah, I deleted half the submissions.
No, I should have more submissions than this. But no, I've gotten headshots that were like club pictures.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Send me a picture and there's a Cadillac in the background, the backdrop, or no, Tupac, or something.
What gets me is the women who submit like half naked pictures.
Oh, yeah.
I've had that as well.
You don't
delete them, though.
But here's the thing, cash me outside.
Ooh, how about that?
How about that?
Here's the thing, though. If you're in Atlanta, and if you're in the industry, and if you heard of Bobby Renee, everyone already knows I'm a married man. So when a woman submits stuff like they have naked pictures to me, it's like, she's from Detroit. I can't save you after that.
I'm coming for you.
What you gonna do? You know what I'm saying? If you're trying to slide, you know, get in on the slide. Look,
some people don't have boundaries. They don't know
be a little bit more discreet in your delivery.
Some people don't know boundaries.
I said, she cute, but maybe you done sent the wrong picture.
Yeah,
I'm not
big
gonna
time.
Terminate this picture.
Big time.
This is not gonna happen. But I don't know. That's just how I am with the whole audition.
Yeah, it definitely frustrates me too. And again, I don't entertain them.
Well,
if you don't send it in the right way.
Yeah, but see, things about me though, because I look at them and I say, man, I seen him in so and so's project. It was really, really good. Like we met a one girl at audition, and she would have gotten the role in Taboo, mm-hmm. the lead role in Taboo. I told her, I said, all you had to do was show up.
All
at
you had
audition.
To do was show up.
We saw her at the audition, but we want her to show up at our audition mm-hmm. to actually have the chemistry with the other actors we already cast.
That's another thing. Don't harass me about a role, and then when it come time to audition, you don't show
and
up.
You don't show up.
Yes.
Don't do that.
Come on now.
That is one of my biggest pet peeves.
What?
You will not get cast in anything else.
Yeah, it's like
because then at that point, you. I mean, I'm like, you a joke.
Yep.
You are a joke. Yep. I cannot stand that.
Yeah,
wow.
Especially.
Well, I don't say they're a joke. They're kind of harsh, but
no, you a joke. We just don't deal with that. I don't like that.
Especially if I'm riding for you too. Mm-hmm. Like if it's a project that I'm working with someone else on, and I'm telling you how good this person is, or how good of an asset this person could be to the project, and then you don't show up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a few times. Then also too, another thing that we had audition when our last live audition we had, this one lady she came in, she was perfect. I mean, she was perfect for the role, but her energy was
so
I don't
off.
Know, as an actor, when you go to mm-hmm. audition, like, is there a process that you do to kind of get the mojo off of you or whatever the case may be? Because
if you're having a bad day, but you have an audition, an in-person audition, how do you separate the two?
Now you have to check that at the door. Mm-hmm. That's work.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So that all comes with your being prepared. As an actor, when you walk in, when that time that you're in that waiting room, that is your time to focus,
mm-hmm.
to do your woo-sahs or whatever it is you got to do to get your mind right and to focus on what you came there to do. It is mm-hmm. not time to chat with all the other actors, try to bring down somebody else's day or whatever. Mm-hmm. You just got to get that out of your mind. You got to walk in there positive. You got to go in, do your thing, and drop it off at the door. That's it. Right.
I mean, because mm-hmm. I was like, man, I'll tell Renee, like, this girl was good. Man, she's really, really good. But think about it. We're very sensitive people when it comes to vibes and energy.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I see our circle is very, very small.
Mm-hmm.
Because when we go around people, whatever case may be, it could be us. Our energy could be off. We don't know. But I was out in the lobby, signing people in because I've been in plenty of audition stuff. We had Spritz helping out. She never really been on audition before. I said, well, you going in with Renee, mm-hmm. run the camera, whatever, and I go out there and liven people up, talking to them, whatever. But her energy from that point, when she signed in, her energy was already off. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It was like, and then Renee, when she went into the room with Renee, it was already off. So when we had a conversation about it, I already knew who she was talking about. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying?
I said she would have been perfect, but I can't cast her because I can't, trust that her energies are going to be good on the day that we have to shoot.
Right. That's right. Like going into in the casting room and telling the casting director that you're nervous. Oh, mm-hmm. I'm nervous. You know what I'm saying?
We've had that happen too.
Yeah, yeah. I tell people that I didn't hear it. Don't tell me. Don't you mm-hmm. tell me that you're nervous.
We had a one girl cry.
Mm-hmm.
She came and she cried.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Man, but we were nice though. We still cast her because I think we just felt sorry.
Yeah.
But we
it was
cast
a small role.
It was a small role,
but
give
you a line.
It was like, come on. Don't cry.
Note to self. Cry in an audition with Bobby and Renee. That's how you get a role.
Yeah, so.
Bobby felt more compassionate
about it. She was hard. I'm like,
I didn't feel compassion for her, but he felt more compassion for her. Yeah. It is what it is. I mean, this is what you're doing. This is what you set out to do. And I expect for you to do just that.
Right.
I don't know. I think I'm more of a
meanie.
No,
yeah,
not
ever
mean.
Since she turned 40, I mean, she's got really, really mean. So.
Oh, now that
Bobby.
I'm 40,
yeah, I mean, she's
Bobby be telling 30. Me, go back to 39.
Seriously, because she just got mean all of a sudden.
Tell me to go back to 39.
Ask all the kids in the house. Like, yeah, she got mean. I don't know what it is.
I don't believe it.
Okay. I'm not mean.
I don't believe it. Mm-mm. I don't think so.
Nope.
I'm trying to tell you, she was mean. On those lonely nights, too, she goes, no, get out of me. I'm like, man, just last month you was all right, but now you turned 40, you're like, don't touch me. What I do?
Now that I'm 40, I'm just not taking a lot of stuff. You know what I'm saying?
I'm just trying to give you some stuff. But
look, Lord, where is this going?
I know. Cover your ears, Rasheda. I'm sorry, because he's about to get an earful.
Look, you've been on with us before. This is how we act.
He's about to get an earful.
This is not nothing we doing for a radio podcast. This is something we talk about all day long.
This is us, y'all.
Yes.
Oh, let me apologize. I know that we've had some hiccups in our Facebook Live broadcasting. Facebook keeps turning the broadcast off, saying we've reached our minute limit or something. So he's having to restart it. So you will see him saying part one, part two, part three. So we do apologize for that, guys. I hope you guys are still tuned in.
Do we got any questions? We got any questions on that?
No. The full length of the video is on the website. So you guys go to the website, instinctradio.net.
That's right.
And you can watch the full video. I haven't gotten any questions yet, but I do have some good response going on from people responding to you, Rasheda.
Oh,
so,
hey, y'all.
So that's awesome. Yeah. So I've really enjoyed, like I said, just following your work, just following you as a director, following you as an actress. I hate that we couldn't get out to the play that you were in, but I've seen some clips. I've seen the pictures, and baby girl, you rocked it. You know which one I'm talking about.
Lipstick
monologues. Yes. Yes.
Chelsea was in that
as well. Yeah. Don't worry. Y'all gonna get a chance to see it again.
Oh, yeah,
we'll definitely be there. I hate that we couldn't come. I don't know what we were doing. We were doing some probably filming.
Yeah, probably filming.
Nine times out of ten,
we didn't have no gas in the car. We're like, man,
y'all the busy ones. Y'all talking about me? Y'all the busy ones?
No, not lately. We haven't been busy lately.
But no, Lipstick Monologues will be back this year. I just got
awesome.
Word,
nice.
So. Now, how did that work? Now, that's not your personal project.
So Lipstick Monologues is written by Audrey Ori.
Okay.
And when she first started it, she lived here in Atlanta. Then she relocated to Chicago with her family, and she asked me to kind of hold the reins while she's away. And so she directs. Mm-hmm. I co-direct and coach the all of the actors, and it's broken up into four sections with four monologues each.
Okay.
And before, we incorporated fashion into it, so it added a different take to your typical monologue show.
Okay.
And it really worked very well. But now we're kind of trying to transition into more of a stage production type show. And so, we've kind of eliminated that fashion portion of it just a little bit, or tweaked it a little bit. But it's definitely a great content, because it deals with everything that women go through.
Mm-hmm.
And each time we do it, it's different.
Okay.
The monologues are different. The themes are different. It's always a different show. And sometimes the cast may be different. We have returning cast members who've been with us from the very beginning. Mm-hmm. And then we bring in new faces as well. Trust me, you will laugh. You're going to cry. You're going to be ready to fight. Mm-hmm. No, I'm just kidding. Not really fight, but it is definitely a great, 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 great production. And we have a male version as well called The Heart of the
Man.
You
know, Renee's an actress. You know,
look
I'm
at
her
him.
Manager.
He always
so
selling.
You got a role for her to be in a lipstick model. Monologue, whatever you call
monologue.
It.
First of all, I'm gonna need my manager to get it together. You hear me?
Right.
We're talking about lipstick monologues. He's talking about being a lipstick model. I don't know.
Help him, Jesus.
You
gotta let me finish the whole word.
Help him.
I was gonna say a lipstick model monologue.
Yeah, okay.
A monologue.
Right.
That's all I was gonna say.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, she does the theatrical stuff.
Okay, well.
That's where I come from.
Because that's why I met her. She was actually doing plays when I first met her.
Really? Mm-hmm. Okay. So, wait, you trying to tell me I might find me a husband at a play?
You might.
Well, sign me up. Who got a play that I can audition for? I got monologues on deck right now.
I know, that's right.
we hang out in the back. That's how we hang out in the back. But it's crazy, though, because at the place she was at, I knew her. I didn't know her like that, but I took a picture of her mom, and her mom said that I liked her.
She did.
Yeah, like her
mom. So you went through her mom to her?
I just took a picture.
Oh,
just
took a picture.
But I just took a picture with her mom, and didn't even know her mom at the time.
Let me go through my Instagram and see who I didn't took pictures with.
I wind up taking a picture with my mother-in-law. The movie, the play that she was in, they wanted to make it into a movie, so they hired me to help out with that. And she was like, well, I've heard of you, Bobby Peoples, this and the third, and how can I be in one of your movies? I'm like, audition. That's how you do it. She said, well, what can I audition? I'm like, well, let this be your audition.
Yeah.
And that's how I started.
But you just didn't know that you was auditioning for, to be a wife,
I was
too.
Auditioning for the major
yes.
role.
Yes. Uh-huh. Yeah, I love it. That is awesome. Bobby, now you're going to have me looking like this every time I walk into an audition. Like, right,
Could this be?
Is it you?
Right.
You never know. Just don't be too reserved, you know, and don't let the man be able to, you know, come to you. Because some girls be coming, you know, you can't say nothing to them.
You know what I'm saying? Unapproachable.
Yeah, unapproachable. You know what I'm saying? So, but you, I don't see you having that problem because even when I first met you, you was a very bubbly person. So, you know, you're a very smiling person. And so, you know, just, hey, I'm Rasheda Randle. How you doing? Because you had your movie,
Love and War. Yes.
And that she won.
Did you win? Y'all, actually, you guys weren't really doing, like the film awards at that time. It was just the best actress.
Okay.
And the
best actor. So now, how many awards have you won?
Two.
You won two awards? Okay. Two. And you were nominated four times, though.
Right.
Okay. So, yeah, she was nominated four times for a TPN award, guys, and she won two of them. Mm-hmm. Four times, two. Okay, so, you know, she's girl, the girl is bad. The girl is bad.
Yeah, she's bad. She's awesome.
Do you have anything in this year, did you? You have anything?
No. Nope. Nothing this year so far. Actually, with Second Chances, I'm hoping to bring that to TPN.
Okay. Awesome. Well, you know
but it might be too long.
How long is it?
30 minutes.
Cut out 10 minutes.
He's pushing it. We'll see the finished product.
So if people want to get in touch with you.
Yeah, I was just going to say that. If people want to get in touch with you, I want you to tell them how they can get in touch with you as an actress and also as a director and writer and producer.
Mm-hmm. Social media. I am on all of the social media sites at Simply Sheeta. That's one E, not two. And Facebook, Actress Rasheda Randle. And you can email me, RasheedaRandle@yahoo.com. That's RasheedaRandle@yahoo.com.
Awesome.
Yes. We're going to have to get you a website going, honey. You got so much going on.
I know.
You're going to have to be able to direct them right to that website.
It's on my list of things to do this year. I just can't get around to it.
You're in Paris all the time.
I know. Paris.
All right, guys. We're going to cut to our break and hopefully we come back. We have some questions to answer from you guys, okay? So we're going on to pay some bills here.
There you go.
Peace.
Honey, I wonder if your wife knows you're here right now.
Your dad plays professional football, right?
Tell us a little bit about the movie.
Hello, indie fans. Today I'm here with Eduardo Castrillo, the filmmaker.
Only with Maverick Entertainment, home to the best indie movies.
Hi, Nancy Day, and I am in Willis, Texas, listening to TPN Live with Bobby and Renee.
I'm standing out here on set. Shoot some stuff on Sunday, on Knucklehead's birthday. What better place to be? All right. And you other filmmakers out there, if you ain't shooting something right now, what the hell are you waiting for? How you gonna get it turned into TPN Film Festival if you ain't shooting? And if you shooting, ain't turn it into TPN Film Festival. What the hell are you shooting for? We out.
What's up, good people? This is your boy Joe Tex Serra from Joe Tex Films, and you're watching TBN Live with Bobby and Renee. Peace.
Yo, what it do? This your boy BJ the Prophet, and you tuned in to TPN Live with my family, Bobby and Renee Peoples. You already know what it is. Yep.
You've been watching TPN Live with Bobby and Renee on Instinct Radio. Be sure to tune in every first and third Thursday between the hours of 8 p.m. and 10 p.m. to hear Mr. Bobby and Mrs. Renee go live with their fans. Thank you for watching.
Oh my gosh, now you know I have to ask. How are you keeping your skin so smooth?
Oh, girl, write this down. It's www.reneesessence.com. Renee's motto is beauty, strength, healing, and nature.
It's Industry with Tina B, and I'm tuned in to TPN Live with Bobby and Renee.
You've been watching TPN Live with Bobby and Renee on Instinct Radio. Be sure to tune in every first and third Thursday of the month between 8 and 10 p.m.
No wasting time at all. We're so phenomenal.
Different flavors make the world go around. And now try the flavor of hot honey mustard on the boneless wings meal. served with crinkle fries, Texas toast, and a 22-ounce drink. Friends, family, flavor. Zaxby's, indescribably good.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're now tuned in to the very best. It's yours truly, Jazzy. Fizzle, fizzle, fizzle.
Mike Stone,
and
Mike
this
Stone.
Is In-State Radio, man. Tune in, baby. Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
All right. Welcome back. Welcome back. So this is the end of, just almost to the end of the show right here. We got a few questions we're going to answer.
Yes.
That was given to us on Facebook. And one of the questions was asked from Rebecca Thompson, who's one of our sponsors.
Yes.
You can see her banner up there right now.
Rebecca.
And her question was, obviously you work well together, but are there any challenges on working together based on different personalities? Mm. So do you have a problem working with me?
Sometimes. And I feel like that was like a bullyish. That was kind of bullyish.
I'm trying to figure out.
I feel like that.
Do you have a different personality when you're working with
me? We do have different personalities. And like we said earlier, we have to sometimes balance each other out.
Yeah.
Because.
Good cop, bad cop.
Sometimes I have to come in and cut some stuff down. You know what I'm saying? Because he is so open to everything free spirited and sometimes I have to come in and play the bad cop, you know. So our personalities, although they are different, they kind of balance each other out.
Yeah, I mean, she do well. She do good sometimes, you know. I ain't mad at her. But, I mean, I guess, you know, we work together on everything. Mm-hmm. Renee and I, you know, we're together 24/7.
Pretty much.
Literally. When we're not together, that's when we got problems.
Yeah.
It's like I'll wake up in the morning. She works from home, you know, her IT job, and I just do whatever I do. I'm doing that day, but we're always together, so it's not like there's any issues there because we're constantly talking about what we're going to do next anyway. So
yeah.
It may be different for us because that's just how we are. We mm-hmm. just happen to have the same interests and love, even outside of the film world. I mean, stuff that we want to do for the community is just stuff that we just combine with.
Mm-hmm.
You have anything you want to say about that, Rasheda?
Working with us.
Yeah, you guys seem to be a pretty good team. I mean, I have yet to see the good cop, bad cop thing.
Well, that's only with the kids.
that ain't just with the kids.
I mean, I think you guys make a really, really, really great team. The dynamic there and the balance, like you said, I can definitely see that.
Cool. All right, so I hope that answers your question. We have another question from Sahara. She says, how did you determine what genre would you focus on when you guys – once you guys got started.
Okay. What genre?
What genres?
Well, we stuck to kind of dramas at first because that's where we were comfortable at.
Stuff we like to watch ourselves.
Right, and then we branched out on, you know, other things. But just in our comfort zone, we started with the dramas.
Yeah. I think that's pretty much what we do. We just, you know, what story can we tell that's going to be oh shit, you know, we just do the old shit factor stories, you know what I'm saying? Like, what would make somebody say, oh damn, that's messed up,
right?
No. So her another question that she asks, what advice would you give to actors who need to polish their skill set and broaden their network?
Train and network.
Mm-hmm.
Don't ever stop learning. Always learn. You want to grow in your craft. You want to hone your craft. So take classes. Go to workshop. Invest in your career.
Yep.
Yes, absolutely.
Invest in it. You know, spend the money. It might be a little pricey. This is probably one of the priciest professions.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, trust me, it's definitely going to take you to the next level. And network. Get out here. Go to TPN Film Fest, go to other film festivals, go to industry events and parties and film premieres and things like that, and put yourself in a position to be around other artists who are like-minded just like you, and I guarantee you are going to come out with so many connections and probably a few bookings.
That's right.
Like I tell people, most of the time, the casting part starts when we first interact with one another.
Say hello.
That's pretty much, you know, we're looking at you now. Okay, mm-hmm. Can I work with this person? How is this person's energy is? So like that. So that's how we go with that. We don't have a lot of time to go here. So we did promise you guys that we're going to show the actual trailer to the movie Fixation.
Yes.
Yeah, so we're going to close out with the trailer. So come back with us next week, in 2 weeks.
Yes.
We got a very, 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 very good show then. This was a great show, Rasheda.
Great show.
I appreciate it. That was shade. No,
I know, right?
It was a really good show with Rasheda here. So we're not going to go any further. We thank you all, you guys, for watching TPN Live with Bobby and...
Me. Thank you.
She's from Detroit. That's all I'm going to say.
Really?
You know, it's cold in the D. Y'all know her cousin.
Don't go there.
You know her cousin. So we're going to say bye. Reach us on TPN1.com to find out what we got going on. And the next film fest is April 28th. So go ahead and roll that trailer to Fixation.
Yay!